This is the very beginning of the recording for Eve Echoes Radio, broadcast number one, full broadcast. Let's see how it works.
Welcome to Larry King Live.
How do you explain Tim Allen?
Sorry,
welcome to Larry King Live.
How do you explain Tim Allen?
Good evening, good morning, good afternoon, good night. I don't care what time it is, all around the world, right now, it's Eve Echoes Radio time. In a world, well, a galaxy, well, like hundreds of galaxies, there was a radio station. It was Eve Echoes Radio. God knows who runs this station. It's been on intergalactic signals for over 50 years. We don't even know what time period these are from. So, I'm DJ Frankie. And I'd like to thank my main news contributor, Mr. Dejers. And I'd like to open up the show by talking about the dev notes from social media. So the devs are kicking in the high gear here, all right? Are all you enjoying the free SP from extended maintenance? Because we at the radio sure are. The patch notes for maintenance include fun little stuff and things like getting rid of the texture bugs on ships, which is awesome. No more flying those fancy monochrome versions of your daily flyer. Hell, maybe they'll release those as skins down the line. In addition, they've changed up the overview settings to make it so you can actually read the level display of anomalies and asteroid belts. Yes! I have been so annoyed by not being able to see the level of the anomaly that I'm about to attack until I set myself to a warp. Oh, it's far easier on the eyes now. And supposedly there are also new effects to the Capsuleer's outposts. So if you've seen one of those out in space, please let us know. DM Evacos Radio, Frankie for Jersey, Djers, DEJEERS. We're all on the main Eve Echoes Discord. You can also message our newest writer, who I can't remember her name right now, and I apologize for that. But the patch notes for maintenance include, you know, the monochrome versions of your daily flyer, they've gone away, they fixed the skins, it's really good. And in addition, they changed up the overview settings to make it so you can actually read the levels for the anomalies and asteroid belts, like I was just saying. And I swear I went southern, even though I'm from New Jersey. Supposedly, there are also new effects on the Capsuleer outposts. I also said that. I apologize. But let us know, for real, if you see one of these new Capsuleer outposts, take a picture, take a screenshot. So there's market animation updates. It's subtle, but there have been a few changes. It doesn't answer the question of when they're getting around to updating the actual market, though. And finally, the bug fixes. A few scary ones here, and a few that people are not happy about. It looks like you won't be able to NOS your own drones anymore. Your autopilot isn't safe from warp disruptors anymore. And let me elaborate a bit on that. Since the game came out, we have been able to easily autopilot AFK or away from keyboard without having to worry about gate campers killing us in low sec and null sec. But it looks like they fixed something that shouldn't have been a bug in the first place, because this is a mobile game and it's meant to be played in short bursts. And when you're jumping from station to station and from sector to sector and whatever it may be, gate to gate, you're supposed to be able to do that offline and not be worried about getting yourself killed. They updated tips on a few items too. So fly safe out there, guys. We're already getting reports of functional gate cams. Otherwise, it's a nice change. It's good to see NetEase is still at work. And guess what we do? We will advertise for your corporation. In fact, I'm going to do an advertisement right now for Ethereal Legion, because Ethereal Legion has been really awesome. They have been focusing on getting rid of botters and scripters in a game, which is making it much, much more unfair of a game. So the Ethereal Legion is a self-sufficient PvP-focused alliance and the executor of the Legion Coalition. The Legion has active pilots all across English-speaking time zones and is led with players with leadership experience both from EVE Online and EVE Echoes, and both. The Legion's actively recruiting corporations and individuals. If you like poop, if you like pew-pew, not poo-poo, if you like pew-pew, have a sense of humor and are not a total jerk, you'll probably fit in well with Elysium. So head to etherealallegion.com. That's etherealallegion.com, etherealallegion.com, for more information on how to join you guys. Now, we're going to head out for another tune. This is another Neil Sick tune. I don't really know what his last name is pronounced like. It's Neil Cicerioga or something like that. Very Italian. But we're gonna bring up that track right now. And this guy has amazing music. He mixes and mashes so many different things from so many different genres. It's just phenomenal. Enjoy.
It's been 1 week since you looked at me, cocked your head to the side and said I'm angry. 5 days since you laughed at me, saying get that together, come back and see me. 3 days since the living room, I realized it's all my fault but couldn't tell you. Yesterday, you'd forgiven me, but it'll still be 2 days till I say I'm sorry.
Hold it, now one wants a hoodwink, does it make you stop, think? You'll think you're looking at Aquaman. I summon fish to the dish, although I like the chalet Swiss, I like the sushi cause it's never touched a frying pan. Hot like wasabi when I boss rhymes, big like Leanne rhymes, because I'm all about value. Bert Kemper's got the mad hits, you try to match wits, you try to hold me but I bust through. Gonna make a break and take a pick out like a stinking naked chick. I like vanilla, it's the finest of the flavors. Gonna see the show cause then you'll know the vertigo is gonna go. Cause it's so dangerous, you'll have to sign a waiver. How can I help it if I think you're funny when you're mad? Trying hard not to smile though I feel bad. I have a tendency to wear my mind on my sleeve. I have a history of taking off my shirt. It's been 1 week since you looked at me, threw your arms in the air and said you're crazy. 5 days since you tackled me, I still got the rug burns on both my knees. It's been 3 days since the afternoon, you realize it's not my fault, not a moment too soon. Yesterday you'd forgiven me, and now I'll sit back and wait till you say you're sorry.
Jamie China, the Chinese chicken, you have a drumstick and your brain stops ticking. Watching X-Files with no lights on, with all amazon. I hope the smoky man's in this one like Harrison Ford. I'm getting frantic, like Stingham Tantric, like speakers guaranteed to satisfy. Like Kurosawa, I make mad films, okay I don't make films, but if I did they'd have a samurai. I'm gonna get a set of better cuts in mind, the kind of tiny enough to so my arms aren't always flying off the backswing. Gonna get into my Sailor Moon cause the cartoonist got the boom anime days that make me think the wrong thing. How can I help it if I think you're funny when you're mad? Trying hard not to smile though I feel bad. I have a tendency to wear my mind on my sleeve. I have a history of losing my shirt.
It's been 1 week since you looked at me, dropped your arms to the sides and said I'm sorry. 5 days since I laughed at you and said you just did just what I thought you were gonna do. 3 days since the living room, we realized we're both to blame, but what could we do? Yesterday, you just smiled at me. Cause it'll still be 2 days till we say we're sorry. It'll still be 2 days till we say we're sorry. It'll still be 2 days till we say we're sorry. Birchmount Stadium, home of the Robbie.
All right, everybody, welcome back. This is EVE Echoes Radio. You're listening live to DJ Frankie, giving you the news and gossip from EVE Echoes through the last day or so. And right now, I'm just pulling up my script. Oh, it's a beautiful thing. The Nullsec Corp, Ethereal Legion, that we had just been talking about, they recently launched an anti-bot operation against PIBC, BAGP, and POI2, or PO12. who they allege are harboring botting corpse within their organization. And I don't mean a corpse, I mean a corporation. After PIBC launched a targeted attack on Ethereal Legion's miners and NPC bases in an attempt to force EL to agree to a non-oppression pact during negotiations, during diplomatic talks, Elysium confronted PIBC about the botting. The ensuing discussion ended with the Ethereal Legion declaring war on PIBC and their allies for harboring bots, exploiting a game, and being just jerks. They're ruining the game for everybody else who's playing it as a normal person. Scripting and botting is not cool. After which, Elysium and the rest of the coalition launched an operation which harvested more than 30 billion ISK of PI from the botting territory. We have an official statement provided by one of the leaders of the Ethereal Legion on this matter, and I quote, "Botters exploit both the community and the developers by scamming the unsuspecting and taking revenue away from the people who built this for us. Everything botters do, directly and indirectly, harms the game we seek to enjoy and the players that seek to enjoy the game. Ethereal Legion does not endorse nor tolerate botting activity, and we refuse to stand by passively and let it take place. We will seek to expose botters and do what we can to disrupt them until they are eradicated. Anybody who supports botting exploits is an enemy of the Legion," end quote. I do not have who that person is, but I'd like to talk about Captain Benzie for a second. Captain Benzie just released a really cool progression video for Railguns. You should check that video out and the rest of his great channel over at YouTube. He has a ridiculous amount about EVE Echoes for new and old players alike. Now, back to the news. NullSec lit up like a firecracker Sunday evening with over 200 pilots duking it out in Genesis Federation's NullSec home system. Opposing Force, OP4S, and Elysium, ELSM, rolled into the system with over 110 pilots in their fleet and caught Genesis off guard. Genesis took a while to muster their defenses before striking out against the invaders. Hours of fleet-on-fleet combat finally culminated in the attackers retreating and Genesis claiming the victory in the ISK war. Reported kill mails tally up to just over 78 million losses for Genesis Federation versus almost 234 million losses inflicting upon those invading fleets. Now, I'd like to play another song for you guys. This is the Aquatic Garden of Extra Celestial Delights from Museum of Consciousness by Spangle. Enjoy. All right, everybody. Welcome back to Eve Echoes Radio. This is DJ Frankie, and that was Spangle from the Museum of Consciousness album, and that was The Aquatic Garden of Extracelestial Delights. What a great song. I really love that band. They are one of my favorite bands completely. So, I'd like to give another advertisement for a corporation. Borg, B-O-R-G, is an industry-focused multi-corporation within the Genesis Federation. They have three full corps of active members in the U.S. and the EU time zones. Finely tuned assimilation protocols allow this corporation to make new and old players alike into functional miners, builders, and drones that can contribute to the collective after. After all, resistance is futile. Let's get into some market information. The minerals and planetary resources are on the rise. And I mean big time. Mass bot bans and the approach of Tech 7 shipbuilding costs have kicked the market into high gear for minerals and planetary resources. So, for an example, spodumene has jumped from 300 ISK to almost 600 ISK per. Many planetary resources have jumped 40 to 60%. We aren't sure how long this will last, but I'd get on it while the getting is good within the next 2 to 4 minutes. Actually, do it 5 minutes ago, really. There's been a Plex update over the last couple of days. Plex has jumped from 85K to over 200K per Plex. That is insane since it started out around 15K. Per. But now it seems to have stabilized around 180. The skyrocketing price isn't forecasted to last long, though, but all our analysis expect Plex to ceiling around 400K not long after people start hitting Tech 7 and getting the second Omega. Remember, folks, the best time to buy Plex was at launch. The second best time was to buy it yesterday. And the third best time is to buy it now. Hold off on dumping your Plex. Hoard it. The train hasn't stopped yet. For those of you looking for a slightly more casual bunch, the Omnitech Corporation has a solid NullSec base that they protect with constant ratting and PvP fleets roaming across their territory. You can feel safe and protected as one of the industry folk or to help guard them. It's an 18 and over corporation with an mature atmosphere, rated M. But it's a friendly leadership team. So if you'd like to join a corporation with over 100 active members that want to help you master the strange and difficult journey of Eve Echoes with the rest of them, then this is the corporation for you. Check them out on their active Discord. This has been Frankie. I'm going to give you guys one more song. So let's see what we can manage to pull up for you guys. A special song that's not on a normal list, and I'm wasting a lot of air because my keyboard is totally dead. So what we're gonna do is get the keyboard plugged in, and then I'll be able to play you this special song that's not on our usual playlist. And I'm gonna do that right about now. This is the Dead South with Gunslinger's Glory. Take care, everybody. Live long and prosper. Wait, that's the wrong one. 07.
Friends. Daniel.